If you are selling on Amazon US and not using the North American Remote Fulfillment Program or Amazon North in short, you are missing your chance to reach more customers. In this video, Rael from C explains how this program allows you to display your inventory on Canada's and Mexico's marketplaces with no extra work. Watch the video to learn more about it. Hi, Rael. I'm really happy to have you here again on Orange Click channel. And today you will talk about Amazon North American Remote Fulfillment Program, which is also known as NARF. But before we go into the details, could you please introduce yourself and also let us know what C does and how do you help Amazon sellers?
Great. Lizette, thank you so much for having me. It's always great to be with Orange Click. Hopefully to add some more value and bring some good information to the seller community that you guys have built. So just introduction for myself. My name is Rael Lowenthal. I'm the Director of Business Development at Z, really one of the founding team members of the company. And we focus really on helping Amazon and other e-commerce merchants expand into international marketplaces through offering a variety of services that makes us a one-stop shop solution to help and enable e-commerce merchants to actually store inventory in marketplaces where they don't have a physical presence or legal entity. I think we can get into a little bit more detail about that towards the end of the session. And I know today I'm here to speak a little bit more about NARF and North American Remote Fulfillment.
Perfect. So yeah, I think first, can you give us a brief overview of what this program is about and which sellers essentially can participate in this program?
Sure. So NARF is the acronym that stands for North American Remote Fulfillment. And really what it means is that anyone with a North American seller account can store inventory in the US, and Amazon will fulfill orders into Canada and Mexico for customers that are based in Canada and Mexico. So it means that the seller doesn't have to actually import the inventory into those countries. The customer in Canada or Mexico can order on .ca or .mx, Amazon websites, and Amazon will actually pick up the goods from the US fulfillment center and get it delivered directly to the customer in that country. Amazon really makes this possible by using a single global ASIN for the clients or the seller's products. So meaning you don't have to have duplicate listings, you don't have to have duplicate products, really. It's your single product or single ASIN, and that will be sold on Amazon.ca and .mx. Prior to 1 July 2022, sellers would actually have to enroll themselves in the program. Starting 1 July 2022, Amazon are actually going to automatically enroll as eligible sellers into the program. The sellers don't need to worry. They will be notified of such at least 30 days before. I mean, we're pretty much approaching the 1st of July very soon. So within the last month, if you do have a seller account, you would have received this notification from Seller Central. There's two ways that you can enroll or unenroll in the program. So that notification that you receive either in your email or on your seller account will have a link to go and give you the option to unenroll if you don't want to be a part of it, if you were automatically enrolled. If you weren't automatically enrolled, then you go into your seller account, you click on the inventory dropdown in the menu, and there's a remote fulfillment option. If you click on that remote fulfillment option, there you will be able to enroll or unenroll your ASINs in either one of the markets. So I think it's important to note, you don't have to participate in both. You can choose which one or the other you want to participate in, or both. Okay, I think before getting into too much of the detail or the pros and cons of North American Remote Fulfillment, I think it's important at this stage really for the sellers to talk about a little bit about customer experience, because while North American Remote Fulfillment does sound very enticing for a seller, it means that you can tap into new markets that you wouldn't have with pretty much relatively low effort and cost. The whole FBA program was designed by Amazon to fulfill prime customer orders within a day. The reason why Amazon gets hundreds of millions of customers to their global websites or marketplaces is because they have focused exclusively on customer experience. So, you know, you get your order within a day. If you don't like it, you can return it, you will get refunded. Really, it makes the process very seamless for the customer. Sometimes the seller has to take a little bit of the hit, especially when it comes to returns and things like that. But really, the customer is the focus, and that's what drives the traffic to the marketplace. And that's why we have millions of FBA sellers, right? Because there's all this traffic that comes to Amazon. In North American remote fulfillment, customer experience is compromised. So meaning that typical prime customer experience that you would get as a prime customer on Amazon isn't the same. You know, sellers really should take this into account when enrolling in the program. So when we talk about customer experience, or when we talk about what actually drives demand for products on Amazon, and not only on Amazon, but everywhere, but obviously today we're speaking exclusively about Amazon. What goes without saying, your quality of your product, you know, and the need for your product is really what's going to drive demand for it, right? Then you're going to have organic ranking, where you need to make sure your listing has the appropriate amount of detail, videos, pictures, things that, you know, customers want to see about your product. Then you can tap into Amazon's paid marketing programs, you know, with PPC, which has become increasingly popular and also increasingly more expensive over time. But again, that really will drive demand for your product. But I think the thing that's definitely left out of this discussion is that customer experience, because at the end of the day, if you got all of it right, you got your PPC, you got your marketing, you got your listings right, everything's great, but the customer has to wait 3 weeks for your order, they're going to choose something else. We live in a world where we want, you know, satisfaction straight away, or immediate satisfaction, and you know, Amazon are almost a bit to blame for that, because they've made it possible for us. So again, customer experience got to be top of mind when a seller is deciding what channels they should be using to sell their products. So now I'm going to talk a little bit about the pros and cons of the program. I'm going to start with the pros. So one of the biggest pros of the program is that a seller is able to test the demand for their product, or see if there is a demand for their product in Canada or Mexico with relatively low cost and effort. So it's literally a matter of, and now that Amazon are automatically enrolling you, you don't even have to do it anymore. But really, it's a click of a few buttons, your listings will be transferred, your reviews will be transferred. The one sort of thing that you have to do is just price the product in the local currency of Canada and Mexico. But once you've done that, your products will be ready for sale in those markets by Amazon. There will be no additional FBA storage fees, because your inventory is already being stored in the US. You'll be charged for that in itself, so you won't be charged additional storage fees for selling in Canada or Mexico. And then I think this is the thing that really gets people to do this, is there's no local tax or import requirements when using North American remote fulfillment, because Amazon is taking care of the fulfillment or the delivery of the order, and the customer is taking care of the import. So the seller doesn't have to, you know, dip their feet into that, and that can be a little bit of a complex world, and that's really why, you know, Z exists. We helping sellers with that all the time. But the, you know, using this program, Amazon have set it up so that the seller doesn't have to really get involved in any import or tax requirements for the sale of their products in those countries. When it comes to the cons, I think one thing that could be easily overlooked, because your products are being priced in Canadian dollars and Mexican pesos, there's an exchange rate that you have to take into account. And if either of those currencies weaken against the US dollar, that means that your product is priced lower in US dollars, which will impact your margins. So you've got to, if you're going to be selling using the program, you've got to be continuously monitoring exchange rate movements so that you appropriately price your products. Customer experience, right? So no next day delivery. Prime customers will wait anywhere between 7 and 12 days to get their goods, receive their orders. And, you know, if you're competing with an FBA seller that can fulfill an order within a day, you're not going to win the buy box. So, you know, unless you're the only one selling in that market, or you've got a very specific product that people want, that you don't have competition doing FBA, it's going to be a little bit difficult because of that. One other thing is that Prime customers, even though they don't have to pay for the international delivery, they do have to pay for import duties at customs. So again, that reduces customer experience or puts a flag in the customer experience. Non-prime customers are required to pay for import duties and international delivery fees, and they will wait longer, sometimes 2 or 3 weeks for an order to be fulfilled. So again, those customers may not be used to a one-day delivery, but you know, if they could get a delivery within 3 or 4 days using the normal channels, again, that's something that they're going to choose. Fulfillment fees, right? So Amazon charge you a percentage of the retail price of your product based on its size and dimensions for each order that they fulfill. If you fulfilled an order out of the US to a US customer, that would be, let's say that fulfillment fee would be a dollar. In Canada, that would be $1.76, so 76 cents more, 76% more. And in Canada, it would be $1.50 or 50% more. So on average. So again, you've got to look at your specific weights and dimensions and size of your products, because some are in the 90%, some are a little bit lower. So again, I just took an average just to give people an idea that if you're going to be using the program, you've got to know that for Canadian orders, you're going to pay an additional 76% fulfillment fees, and you've got to take that into account in your selling price. And because of those higher fulfillment fees, you might price yourself out of the market. So you've got to just be careful, you know, take that into account and make sure that your pricing is accurate. Amazon won't sell any product on this program. So there are eligibility criteria for certain products which are and aren't allowed. I'm going to talk specifically around the ones that aren't allowed. And Amazon really categorized the products that won't be fulfilled using North American remote fulfillment in three categories. There's restricted products, prohibited products, and dangerous products. I'm just going to give you some examples. Amazon go in quite extensive detail about, you know, what is allowed and what isn't. But a restricted product, some examples would be alcohol, fine art, cosmetics, skincare, or dietary supplements. Prohibited products, this would include vehicle tires or stored value instruments. So if you're selling gift cards, that won't be allowed to be sold by the program, and loose package batteries. Then Amazon define dangerous products as a product that has a regulated substance or material that may be flammable or dangerous during transport. So it could be corrosive, it could be pressurized, in which case it would be dangerous during transport, and those wouldn't be allowed. So some examples of those would be laptops, smartphones, so anything with a battery could be corrosive or flammable, household cleaners, sprays, or cosmetics. So again, you know, if you're in those categories, this may not be the right program for you. So talking around eligibility, Amazon are constantly re-establishing or researching the eligibility criteria for products. And generally speaking, if a product changes its eligibility, so meaning it goes from ineligible to legible or vice versa, that would be because of a change in trade regulation of the country that you're importing to. So the reason it may be ineligible is because at customs, a certain document or testing certificate or something like that is necessary for import. And they don't want to put that obligation on the customer because the customer is the importer, in which case they make it ineligible. But I think where sellers could get confused is that some products may be ineligible on North American remote fulfillment, but they would be legible using FBA. And the reason being is because the products are being imported by the seller using FBA, in which case the seller would arrange to have whatever documents are necessary to get those products in. So don't be confused if you could sell it via FBA or if you and Amazon is saying you can't do it via North American remote fulfillment. There's a specific reason why that would be the case. So really, as a conclusion, North American remote fulfillment gives sellers with a North American seller account a relatively cheap and easy way to understand if there is demand for products in either Canada or Mexico. True demand for those products will never be reached using that program because of the lack of or bumps of in the customer experience journey. So prime customers are by far the biggest spenders on the platform, and because they aren't able to get that next day delivery experience, that will it won't allow for a true demand to be tested. So really, FBA is the superior model of understanding the true demand for your products in an international country. And you know, a partner like Z would help you actually get there. But if you wanted to understand, look, should I be even looking to expand to Canada or Mexico? North American Remote Fulfillment is a great way to do that, because it'll tell you whether you know, your ACEs actually have any kind of demand or not for little cost and effort.
Okay, very good. Thank you so much for this detailed overview. So I wanted to ask, so once sellers have started using the program, and let's say they have been using the program for a while, and then they think that, okay, now I would like to stop using this program, and I would like to send a separate inventory to either Canada or Mexico, how can they deactivate this program, or can they just cancel it?
Yeah, so in their seller account, they will, so that actually brings up another good point. So I'll talk about that afterwards. But yeah, they go into their seller account, they go to the inventory drop down in their seller account, and there's an option called remote fulfillment. If they go there, that is where they can unenroll their ASINs from the program. You mentioned an important part or point. If you want to sell your product via FBA in those countries, you can't or you shouldn't have it on remote fulfillment and FBA, because then your products basically compete with each other. And because there's different ways of fulfillment, so you're going to basically have two ways of trying to get the same buy box. That's you're just putting yourself at a disadvantage. So if you do decide to go via FBA, you should be deactivating North American Remote Fulfillment.
Considering the pros and cons of this NARF program, what do you think for who Amazon actually designed this program for?
The program is designed for Amazon. I think let's put it that way, right? Like, Amazon are doing it because it brings in an additional revenue stream for them, and the seller doesn't have to do much in order to do it. So from Amazon's perspective, you know, even if a seller sells an additional 5 units a month, that's still marginally better for them than it was before. If you're looking at it from the seller's point of view, I think you're right, you're 100% right. If the seller doesn't have any competition in that market, they would see pretty good success. I think, again, when it comes to eligible products, it's going to be sellers who sell relatively simple products from a compliance perspective. You know, anything that doesn't fit in those three categories that I mentioned earlier. And then again, I don't think North American Remote Fulfillment, I don't think any seller could rely solely on North American Remote Fulfillment to get additional income from other countries. I think this program is set up for very established US sellers who in going international may not, you know, the effort to do so may not be where they want, but they do want to sell internationally and they don't have to do so much to do that. That's generally who it's best for. And then I think, again, it's a good tester to see whether you should be entering that market without having to use a tool like Helium 10 or Jungle Scout to understand or do research on the demand, but actually physically implement a demand tester for the product in those markets.
Okay, very good. So thanks again for giving this detailed overview about this NARF program. And once more, could you explain what kind of services Z offers for Amazon sellers and how you can help them with different topics?
Great. No, and thank you so much for having me here. It's always great to be on the show and or to be, you know, be providing some value to the listeners. From Z's perspective, we offer international expansion services for Amazon and other e-commerce merchants. We do that by offering two very distinct offerings that, you know, bring into account everything that you need in order to go international. So the first is a global trade compliance service, and that consists of getting your entity and your products ready to trade in a different country. So that, for examples, would be getting a VAT, JCT, or GST registration, completing the filings for those registrations, and then also getting your products both legal for sale and import in those countries. So getting all the necessary testing and other documentation that's required, and, you know, anything that needs to be on the product labels, so that it can be legally imported and sold in that country. And then we have an import compliance service, which consists of an importer of record service. So Z actually acting as your local representation in that country for import purposes, as well as transporting the products from your manufacturer or your warehouse to the Destination Country Fulfillment Center. So really, we take care of the entire end-to-end compliance and supply chain that's required to sell your products internationally, so that the seller can focus on what they need to sell, what they need to focus on, which is actually getting their sales right. So that gives them the time to focus on PPC listings, adding new products, and then, you know, we taking care of making sure that all the products actually arrive in that fulfillment center so that Amazon can fulfill those orders.
Okay, very good. So thanks again for joining me, and I hope to see you soon again.
Great. Thanks, Lizette. Thanks for having me.
I hope this video helped you to understand better what NARF program is. If you enjoyed the content we create, then don't forget to click the like button below the video and also subscribe to our Orange Click YouTube channel. And now I will recommend you to watch the workshop we did together with CE experts, where they explain everything about expanding an Amazon FBA business globally.